Back in 1968, I was learning how to clone stem cells. And back at that time, just a handful of people in the entire world even knew what a stem cell was. So I was in the right place at the right time to make some interesting discoveries. I put one stem cell in culture by itself. It divides every 10 or 12 hours. At first it's one, then 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, doubling. So I have 50,000 genetically identical cells. That's not the experiment, this is. I split the cells into three different petri dishes. And what I do is I change the chemical composition of the culture medium. Culture medium is the equivalent of blood. So if I'm growing mouse cells, then what I do is look at mouse blood, see what it's made out of, and then try to make a synthetic version of that called culture medium. So here's the point. Genetically identical cells in three dishes, but slightly different environment because of the chemistry. In one dish, the cells form muscle. In a second dish, the cells form bone. And in a third dish, the cells form fat cells. Significance? What controls the fate of the cells? Point? They were all genetically identical. The environment is what was selecting the genetic activity of the cells.
People who have the same DNA, who have the same susceptibility to illness, one can become ill and the other can stay well. One can heal and the other can't, all because they optimize the environmental factors that control gene activity. And that's what the field of epigenetics is all about.
The nature of biology is simple. Biological organisms adapt their biology to fit into an environment. So if I change my perception, my mind, change my belief about life, I change the signals that are going in and adjusting the function of the cell. The point is very, very significant. I, by my ability to change my environment and by my ability to change my perception of the environment, have the ability to control my genetic activity. I'm not a victim of my heredity, I'm a master of my genetic activity.